when his guy doesn't come, instead of just running by Mosa, he's got to give his tackle Lucas a little help. He's got to edge him. That's the best player on the field. Your little check down isn't going to matter if the quarterback's on his back. He's got to give some presence there to his tackle. You see what happens if you don't?
Got to have it. 4th and 14. Got it for the 35. Steps in. Puts it deep down the field. It's under throw.
From Metcalf through this game when he went on target at the break, pointed out, and that just was a clear boil over moment where he grabbed Fred Warner, two hands on the face mask after what had happened by throwing Warner down every lateral of the ball. This has been the line, guys, the line of balance with DK Metcalf and his current trying to control these emotions and the passions that he plays with. And there you saw it boil over.
I think Big Dom's thinking right now.
He's glad that someone else is involved.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 14 of Seattle. Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 2 of San Francisco. Both number 14 and number 2 are disqualified. It's first down, San Francisco.
That's interesting. The initial scuffle was between DK and Fred Warner. And I think Lenoir kind of came to the rescue and took a shot. Watch. So this D'Amador Lenoir is just coming in, standing up for Warner, and that's why he's included in the ejection alongside with DK.
So back-to-back weeks, the 49ers have a player ejected. Last week was Trent Greenlaw. This week they get Lenoir, but it was Metcalf who was in the game.
Came in and gave him a shove. I don't know if that necessarily constituted being ejected.
Let's go to Dean Blandino. Dean, is that an ejectionable offense by the Warriors? We'll get back to Dean in a second. Not sure I heard us there.